Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty, Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a full metallic design. We're going to do a 3D flower and it's all going to be super shiny metallic. Yes, my hair has changed again. Didn't stay completely blonde for long. Got a bit bored of that. Here we have a nail that I have magically created with my brush. This is my magic wand. You ready? I just went abracadabra, alakazam, abadabadishabadishaboom, like that, and I created a nail. Try it at home, it might work. To create this nail I have used cameo pink. And it's obviously a ballerina shaped nail. This is not a coffin nail. Ballerina. And what we're going to do is we're going to start with a base of top coat. When you're doing metallics, you need a base of top coat. If you don't do this, it will go matte. Which, fair enough, if you want a matte metallic, then don't use a base coat. So the actual base that we're putting down is not, it is not the Urban Graffiti base coat. We are using the Urban Graffiti top coat as our base. This way it works better. I have had people on Snapchat contact me saying, why does this not work? Oh my God. They didn't talk like that, obviously. But the reason most people struggle with the metallic is because they put down base coat instead of top coat. Now I know that sounds a bit weird, but we're putting the top coat as our base coat. Okay, can I be any more clear? Do you understand?
I understand.
Well, there we are then, everybody must understand. To create our 3D, I'm gonna use a 3D sculpture gel. Yes, this is gel, and we're gonna sculpt it. This is what it looked like. This is what looked like, duck. This is what it looks like. I'm going to tear that to open it. It's like opening a fresh can of coffee. But this is a lot nicer. Because look at that. Beautiful. We need, you'll need a cuticle knife or a cuticle pusher, anything that's metal. Not the kitchen knife. You will also need some kind of dampened dish or a little pot like this. And you're going to put some gel residue wipe-off solution into there. Now this is going to be the solution that helps you move the gel around. Take that out and then I can shut this. This is like, do you know when you have butter?
Yeah.
And it comes with that.
Do you have to keep that on?
See, I do for a bit, but then it really, really does me head in.
Because it starts keeling up.
Yeah, and it gets all messy and everything. Mm. And I end up taking it off. And I thought, why didn't I just take it off in the first place? Do you take it off? Mm. Or do you put it back down?
Yes,
do you
put
the foil
down?
Back down?
I don't know.
But it's like a piece of plastic.
Is that not your job?
I don't pay enough attention.
So we're going to use this. Well, I'm just going to flatten it out a little bit so I can kind of see how much I've got. Because it's very deceiving. Oh, look at that pattern already, I like that. Right, so then we're going to work from the outside in. We're going to scrape some off. And we're going to pop that down. And with a 3D brush that's damp with the gel residue wipe-off solution, we are going to mould the petal shape. This is an awesome product if you struggle with acrylic, because this will not set as you are working it. You can just keep playing with it.
Why do you use gel res?
The gel residue wipe off solution has got an ingredient inside that helps it not to stick, so the brush won't stick to it. First petal, gonna cure that, pop that in. I'm going to get my next little bit. And then I will pop that on. You can bring that out. Just need to flash cure that. Pop that on. Don't be like too worried about putting it on in the shape that you need it, because you're going to use your brush to do that. I don't want to go too close to the edge, because when you're using metallics, if you go really close to the skin and it touches the skin, it's quite hard to get off the skin. Flash cure me that.
Flash.
And you're going to press it just like you would do acrylic. Same angles. So as you get to the centre of the flower, your angle of the brush will be more upright. And the next petal. So we're going to overlap this one here. Overlap here, overlap here. Just look at this colour on its own, as beautiful as gold is. And flash! Nee 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 nee. do here is I'm going to do another portion of a flower. It won't be a complete flower. Still working with this rose shape. So I've added some scrolly kind of filigree kind of shapes as well. And we've cured all that now. So it's like rock art. Look at that, unbelievable. It's magic. What we're gonna do now is use the Urban Graffiti top coat. Now we're gonna use this sparingly. Like it's the last thing on earth and you need it. So you've got to use it very, very sparingly. Rationing every drop. Have I gone a bit far? So you're going to coat the nail and all the design. You see, I'm sort of stabbing it into the design rather than just going and laying it all on. Doing this stabbing technique, if you could call it a technique, will help to get into all of those nooks and crannies. So we need it all to be covered with the top coat. But we need to not take away from the 3D too much. It will take away a little bit of it because it'll fall into those little dents. So So what you need to do is just remove any excess. You can do that with the tip of the brush like this. And you can also get your 3D brush. Make sure it's nice and dry. And you can just take any excess off with that as well. And the brush will just lift anything out. Next, we're going to use some beautiful metallic. It is this colour, basically. It's bronze. Got to get this nice and neat at the cuticle. This is the most difficult part. Why are you covering that gorgeous gold? Because I'm doing a full metallic flower. You cannot create this look any other way. You could do it in acrylic. However, it's kind of easy to do it with the gel. So we're going to let that dry. So this looks like an antique kind of frame kind of stuff. Is there a word for it? Like a, I know it's not gold, but you know, like them goldy filigree frame things.
Like they do in my picture frames and all that.
Yeah. So we're going to let that dry. And as it dries more, it will go shinier and it will also be clearer. The flower will be clear. So you've got that cool antique effect. I'm going to seal it. Obviously, you've got to seal it as well. We're going to seal it with the same top coat. This works best with the Urban Graffiti top coat. Don't be tempted to put mega gloss over the top because it will slightly diminish the shine.
It's a lot thicker, isn't it, mega gloss?
Yeah, it is thicker as well. So you can create your design in any colour you want to, really, because we're covering it up. I just use the gold because it's pretty and I wanted to show you. What we're going to do now is just add a few stones, and I'm going to do that with mega gloss. I can use mega gloss over the top of the Urban Graffiti top coat because it's already sealed. All I'm going to do is pop a little bit on them. So I'm going to use a dotting tool for that. Mega gloss. And put it where I want it. Because the mega gloss is thicker, it'll hold the stones on better than the Urban Graffiti top coat. Won't fit there. So there we are. That's all finished. I am going to use some cuticle oil. Freesia. Or freesia. Whatever that word says. There you are. Look at that. That's bloody gorgeous, Duck. That is. Oh, Duck, it's a bit gorgeous. So there you are. An antique 3D metallic nail design. How beautiful is that? Hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All of the products we've used today will be listed below, ready for you to just easily click and have a little look. So I will see you guys in the next video. Please keep watching. No one wants to be defeated. Show them how funky strong is your fight. It doesn't matter. Right.